Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمد ونستعينه ونستغفر ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير هدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أما بعد عباد الله في قول مشهور عندنا الأفعال تتحدث بصوت أعلى من الكلمات الأفعال تتحدث بصوت أعلى من الكلمات We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as it is His right to be praised and we seek help from Him and Him alone we seek His aid He is the one that will aid us when we are in need We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We seek refuge with Him from the evilness of our own selves, from our own false pride. I bear witness, that there's no deity. There's no deity in reality that deserves to be worshipped except Allah alone, having no partners whatsoever in His creation. Having no partners in whatsoever in His providing to His creation. Having no partners whatsoever in His managing all the affairs of His creation. He is alone. He is the one who gives life and He gives death. He is the one where the truth lies. I bear witness that Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, he is the servant of Allah. And he is the messenger of Allah. And he is his final messenger. And there is none that come after him. And we send, and we ask Allah to send the prayers and blessings and the security upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and upon his family, his wives, his offspring, and his companions, and everyone who follows him in righteousness to the last day. Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says in the Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah as it is his right to be feared. And do not die except for that you are in the state of al-Islam. He says, O mankind, fear Allah as it is his right to be feared. Be in awe of him and how magnificent he is, how glorious he is, how great he is. Allahu Akbar, he is above everything. He is greater than everything. And his statements are lasting. Fear him. And know that he created you, each and every one of us, every man, woman, child, believer, disbeliever, red, black, white, yellow, whatever you may be. Whatever tongue you may speak from, whatever it is your language, whatever land that you were born in, he is your creator. Know that. And fear your Lord with regard to that fact. And also fear him with regard to the family ties. Never break the family ties, brothers and sisters. No matter how hard things may get, how difficult it may be patient with your family members. Be close to them, be near to them. Call them to the greatest speech. Call them to the greatest call, which is La ilaha illallah and nothing other than that. Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with regard to when you ask your rights. And know that he is indeed watchful, all aware. He doesn't become tired. He doesn't become lazy. He doesn't sleep. He's forever watchful over everything that we say and what we do. Allah says what means, all you have believed, be mindful of your Creator and speak a straightforward word. And by doing so, he will rectify your affairs. He will straighten things out for you. And whoever obeys Allah and obey the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then without any doubt, this person will be successful. After that, we say that the best of speech is the book of Allah, the Quran, the kitab of Allah, the book of Allah. All of it is the word of Allah, the speech of Allah, and it is not created. And Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the best guide on how to understand that book, that great book, that word that Allah sent down. He is our example. And everything that is innovated, introduced into this religion of ours, is misguidance. And every misguidance and everything misguided will be in the fire. After that, we mention a statement that is very well known. Al-af'alu tatahaddathu bi sultin ala min al-kalimat. Actions speak louder than words. Actions, al-af'al, they speak louder than words. It is incumbent upon us, brothers and sisters, that we do what we say. It is time today to change, to make a difference in our own lives, to make a difference for this ummah, and be of those who are truthful in speech. Be of those who are real adherents to what they say they believe in. How many times do we hear in the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he addresses us, all you who say you have believed. You say you believe. You spoke in a word. You say that you're Muslim. Then there's actions that must come after that. You must do something. You can't just say that you're Muslim. This is not a thing that Allah likes. He says, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, لِمَا تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ كَبْرَ مَخْتًا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَن تَقُولُوا مَا لَا تَفْعَلُونَ He says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, all you who say you believe, why do you say what you do not do? Why is it you making this statement, but you don't act upon it? It is a great hateful thing in the sight of Allah that you say something, that you say you're about something, you claim in something, but you don't act upon it. You do not do what you say. This is hateful in the sight of Allah. Allah Azza wa Jal, what does He say? All you who believe, kunu qawamina bil qist. All you who believe, stand up firmly. Be just. All you who believe, la tasquru qawman ala qawm. Do not mock one another. Do not make fun of one another. Do not belittle another person. All you who believe, isbiru, be patient. Don't be so hasty. Everything that Allah commands us to do, it is for us. It's for those who say they believe, those that say that they're Muslim. Do we pray five times a day? On time, we've entered into this contract. We say, Ashhadu la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. What does that mean? I bear witness that there's no deity worthy of worship but Allah. That means I'm going to worship Him. I'm going to obey Him in all of His commands. I'm going to abandon everything that He has said, stay away from, don't do. I'm not going to second guess it. I'm not going to think about it. Except for if I think about the harms it is in me staying away from what He said. It's upon us today, brothers. It is upon us today to ask Allah for forgiveness. To ask Him for forgiveness for our negligence in being true Muslims. And being people that stand for what they say they stand for. You say that you're Muslim, but you do not act like a Muslim. You say that you're Muslim, but you don't behave like a Muslim. And if we are like this, perhaps we don't know what a true Muslim is. A Muslim has to know his religion. It is not enough for us to stop where we begin. To enter Islam, to learn how to make wudu, to learn how to pray, to know that we should fast, but we should understand everything with regard to these actions that we're supposed to do and strive every day to increase and be better and try to perfect our worship to the greatest, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's promised you, He's promised me, He's promised all of us, Jannah. He says, "Inna al-muttaqina lahum jannah." Indeed, for the believers, they have jannah for them. They have jannah. Do we want jannah, or do we want the nar? It's time to act upon our beliefs, learn our religion. There will come a day, brothers, that if we do not do what we're supposed to do this day, there, and we don't act, we don't speak the truth, meaning we act upon what we say. If our faith is not a reality, because the faith is what? It is first al-iqrar bil qalb, affirming it in our heart. When nutq lil lisan or bil lisan, and pronouncing it, saying it with our tongue. Wal amal bil jawarih, and acting upon it with the rest of our limbs. If we don't do that, those same limbs, that same tongue that Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you, it will speak against you on that day where Allah says, Hadha yawm la yuntiqun. This is the day when you will not be able to speak, but rather everything will speak for you or against you. The book of Allah, the Quran, is hujjatan laka alayk. It's a proof for you or against you. You read it, or you should read it. You try to understand it. Do you look at those words and they're just empty statements? Or do you take them to your heart and try to understand them and ponder upon them and put them into action? And if you don't understand, how do you seek knowledge, seek people who know to help you and aid you to understand? And this is what we should all do. The Islam is not just I pick up a book and I read it and I practice it. Because sometimes we may not understand. Yes, there are things that are clear, have no problem about it whatsoever. But we should take it to those who may know or may understand, or just to clarify, do we understand what we think we understand? We have to not be arrogant to think that we can't talk or be taught to learn from those that may be older than us or younger than us, whatever the situation. The arrogance has to go. That follows you into all of your actions in your life. When you harm yourself, you harm those who are around you. Make a promise to yourself. Make a promise to Allah. To be of those who, when Allah says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, or you believe, you open your ear, you open your heart, and you take in what Allah is going to say, and you implement whatever it is that He commands. أقول قولي هذا فاستغفر لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, al-af'al, actions, tattahadathu bi sultan ala min al-kalimat. Actions speak louder than words. We've reached and we're in the month of Ramadan, of Rajab. And what is approaching us near is the month of Ramadan. We have between us Rajab, Sha'ban. And then the month of Ramadan, the month where Allah says, Kutiba alaykum as-siyam. It has been prescribed upon you as siyam, fasting. Kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum. As it was prescribed upon those who came before you. La'allakum tattaqoon. So that you can be more conscious of your Creator. That you can be more conscious of Allah. The month of fasting. That those who really love Islam, they have some zeal. They can't wait for it. Not like those who, when they hear it's coming, they wish that it wouldn't come. Wa'iyadhu billah. They wish that it could be put off. Why is this part of the religion? Why do I have to suffer for so many hours? Is there another way? Instead of being happy with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Being happy with the decree of Allah is an action that we must have. A good action. Not being sad. Well, Allah says, وَبَشْرِ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُ مُصِيبَةٌ. Give glad tidings to those who are patient. Whenever some difficulty comes to them. So Allah has decreed things that we like and they dislike. But we are patient. We're patient in our times of hunger. We're patient in our times of loss of wealth. We're patient in the times when we lose someone. And he said, all that they say in these times, it says, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. They understand that we are from Allah, we belong to Allah, and to Him we will return. They're patient. So the month of Ramadan is coming. And most likely we will start to listen to and hear things talking about the virtues of the month of Ramadan. But we cannot wait. Again, we remind, do not wait till the last minute. Prepare yourselves for the month of Ramadan. Sisters, if you have not completed your siyam, your fasting from the previous year, do so now. Don't let another Ramadan come and go. You haven't completed what is owed to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Likewise, brothers, if you were sick or traveling and you forgot to make up your salat, do so. I mean, your siyam, your fasting, please do so before Ramadan comes. And for those of us that have it completed everything, let's get ready. Let's prepare ourselves. The Ramadan, this beautiful month of fasting, this beautiful month to achieve taqwa. Let's have a real Ramadan. A real one. People, they prepare. We watch the March Madness. We watch the sports. We do all those things. We prepare ourselves. Like those people who are participating in those sports. They prepare themselves day in and day out, practicing. So that when they hit the court, when they hit the field, whatever it is they do, they're able to do their best. They're in it to win. We should be in Ramadan to win it. So before entering Ramadan, we must practice. We have enough time now to begin reading the Quran. Go take it and dust your Quran off. Open it up. Begin to read it. Learn how to pray properly. There's pillars of our prayer. And one of those pillars is what's called a tahiyyat. A tahiyyatu lillahi wa salawatu wa tayyibatu. Assalamu alayka ayyuhal nabi wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Do we all know that we must say that in the prayer when we're sitting? This is a pillar of the prayer. So if you have not learnt that statement, if you don't know what to say, you need to come learn it. Are your prayers being accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are your deeds being accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Sometimes we're doing things we don't even know if we're doing them right. Seek help. Don't be ashamed. It's okay. Don't be arrogant. It's okay to learn. It's okay to be wrong. It's just not okay to be happy and content with your wrongness. The month of Ramadan is coming. Open the Quran. Read the Quran. Begin your siyam this month. Begin your siyam in the month of Sha'ban. Fasting the siyam of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Following his example. Pray more. Get up. Pray tahajjud now. Don't wait till Ramadan to pray tahajjud or taraweeh or whatever you want to call it. Don't wait for that time only that you stand in the night for Allah after Isha. It is not restricted to that month. What is better to do it outside of that month as well. The worship, the actions that we claim, that we show that we're beautiful Muslims during the month of Ramadan, of helping others, being kind with each other, that's supposed to be shown throughout the year, not for 1 month. That is hypocrisy. Show the reality of your Islam every day. Practice your Islam now. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us, to aid us, to guide us, to give us strong faith. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us for our sins and our misdeeds, our negligence. We seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the evil of our own selves. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who enter Jannah without any hisab. We ask Him to place all of us together and meet again in Jannah, and that He remove us and keep us far from the fire. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He give us for the remaining days we have on this earth to give us nothing but good in those days, and He protect us from all the evil that's surrounding us. Aqimu salat.
Allahu Akbar. أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله